Hey everybody, it's Monica. So I'm here to show you how I created my gilded backgrounds using die cuts for the masculine cards that you saw previously on my Butterbee Scraps masculine cards DT project. I'm actually going to be showing you two different things. I'm going to show you how I used it with die cuts and score tape, and then I'm also going to show you how to use it with stencils and score tape. So what you're going to need, let's start off with, you're going to need a die cut piece, you're going to need your adhesive, and you're going to need your flakes. So what I did is I created a panel. This panel is 6¼ by 4¾, I believe. Let's just make sure. Yes, because this is going to be for my 6 bar cards. So this, for this size, I'm going to go ahead and use a die cut piece. I'm going to use a piece you guys are familiar with because it's a full panel piece. This is the Cherry Lynn Mediterranean Lace Frame. So there's that. And then I'm going to go ahead and use, let's pick a bright color. Let's use Autumn Leaves Gilding Flakes. So we're going to have that. So you don't need anything else as far as what any other products. You don't need the fluid glitter and flake glue like you use with your indigo blue or the cosmic shimmer when you're stamping. Your adhesive for this is going to be score tape. Now you can buy the 6x6 panel, or you can do what I did to make it any size that I want. I used the 2.5-inch roll, and I basically laid it out on an 8.5 by 11 sheet, and then I cut panels from that so I can get my own desired size. Since 6.5 is very specific, I didn't want to lose that little strip when I was going to be cutting my panel out. And this one is larger than 6 inches. So one thing that I will note, when you're lining up pieces of tape, there's right where it meets up, each tape, right where it meets up, you will see that line on the gilded panel. I don't really mind it too much, especially if you're going to be covering it with die cuts, because the die cuts will draw most of the attention away from it, and you can maneuver and cover it if it really bothers you. For me, it's not a big deal. Let's see, let me pull a card. So there's this card, and oops, you actually have the bag that is in the way. So here, if you can see, let's see, right here is where you see the line of where the tape meets. That doesn't really bother me too much. It's not too big of a deal. Only people really, really looking at the card, and I mean really nitpicking, or whatever project it is, whether it's not a card, are gonna be able to see where it joins. It's completely gilded and covered, but you can still see the line. I don't mind. So to start off with, go ahead and get some copy paper or cardstock, anything thin and cheap to place underneath, because your flakes will get all over the place. It's just like working with glitter, so you want to have something to catch the excess flakes and funnel it back into your container. So we are going to go ahead and we're going to remove the adhesive backing. And you want to make sure too that you really burnish the tape into the cardstock. And keep one, at least one of these, the release paper, because you want to go ahead and use it to push down your cardstock, die cuts, whatever it is you're laying down as your back piece, onto your panel. Because you want to make sure all the cardstock is on the adhesive properly so flakes don't get underneath it and ruin your piece. So I'm going ahead and lifting all of my adhesive. So now I have my cardstock panel that has score tape all over it. So here I'm going to take my die cut and I'm going to go ahead and line it up. Now this frame is smaller, and I make sure I'm in camera. Yes. Ah! This frame is smaller. This is going to leave quite a border on the outside, which is good. So about there is what I wanted. So since it's sticky, I'm going to use the release paper to go ahead and really press down my die cut. So I'm going to do it all over the frame to make sure it gets properly adhered down. So now that it looks like everything is down, We're gonna go ahead and grab our flakes. And I also did forget to mention also, you need either the indigo blue scoochie foam to go ahead and burnish in the flakes, or you can use the Ranger Rub It Scrub It pad. This is what Sue Wilson uses when she uses her creative expressions. The scoochie foam comes from Indigo Blue. I would probably use the Rub It Scrub It. I'll probably cut a piece off because it has more support due to the foam backing. This is just squishy. Alrighty, so here we have our piece. You can go ahead and get rid of these. And let's go ahead and get our flakes. Now you are not gonna need a whole bunch of flakes. This is something that is very, very easy, and the flakes will go a long, long way. So let's open this up. So here you have all the flakes. Now you can just go ahead and grab pinchfuls, and you're just gonna go ahead and drop it all over your cardstock. And it doesn't matter if it gets off, you can always grab extra pieces. And that's about all you're really gonna need. I mean, let me grab another little pinch just to make sure I have extra, because you're gonna spread this around and work it into the cardstock. Let me go ahead and close this up for now. So with my foam, I'm gonna go ahead and hold down a part of the cardstock so I'm not holding the sticky. And just go ahead and in a circular motion, go over your cardstock and over the flakes. And you're gonna really work that flake into all of those adhesive areas. And you just keep working it around. And once I get all the excess flakes, you'll be able to really see. And just get the extra, the other crumbs and bits that you have that start coming off. You can use that towards the pieces of adhesive that are still showing and just work it in. It's really, really easy. It's super fast. It doesn't take a long time, and it gives you a very elegant looking card. So everything is pretty much in. So I'm just going over it one last time to make sure any excess little loose pieces are off. So as you can see, my entire cardstock panel is covered. So with these, you can either choose to dump the excess little bits, or you can put it back in the bowl. I put it back in the container as much as will fit. Ooh, I have the air conditioning on, so they're starting to fly everywhere. But luckily, I'm not directly over the vent. So, as you can see, you have your completely gilded panel. It is completely smooth. It's refined. It is in all the little areas of the die cut. And did I do it a little crooked? No, it's okay. It's not bad. So as you can see, I'm not sure if you can pick it up on camera, but this Autumn Leaves is the one that has the pinks and teals and greens and golds and copper. I hope you can pick it up. It's gonna suck if you can't. If not, I can also add a picture at the end of the video in case it doesn't appear properly. But it is all over the entire card panel. It's absolutely beautiful. And that's it. It's just a few minutes that it takes to get this done. And then you can lay this on whatever project you're gonna be doing. Now, to do a stencil background, it's pretty much the same thing. Let me go ahead and get another piece of copy paper. I need a smaller one for what I'm going to do. So here I have a larger panel. I'm using a 5 1/4 stencil. This is a Hero Arts stencil, and it is, here's the package. It is the Floral Filigree Stencil Pair, and I got this at Joann's. So I have my stencil. So now I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to take the adhesive from the adhesive release paper from my panel off, and I decided to put this on black cardstock because what I'm going to go ahead and do, since I'm using a stencil, I'm going to lay the stencil down, I'm going to gild the open areas, then I will then remove my stencil and I will be adding glitter. I chose black paper because I decided to use my Distress Stickles, the dry glitter, the Clear Rock Candy. Because as you guys all know, I love dark colors. Black is my favorite color. I mean, they say it's not really a color, but to me it is. So I have my panel ready. Ooh. And I'm going to go ahead and set it to the side for just a second because you need to prep your stencil. You don't want your stencil to permanently adhere to your background. So I'm going to go ahead and lay my stencil down. And if I can find it. And of course, I'm having technical difficulties looking for what I need. Because I wasn't prepared and I did not have it out. Now let's see where I put it. I am looking for, here we go. I was looking for my perfect medium. So I'm just gonna go ahead and cover my stencil with the perfect medium. I haven't used Versamark. I'm pretty sure Versamark will work. This is just to keep the stencil sticky so it doesn't, stick permanently to my card piece. And I am just making sure that I am getting everything covered. Okay, so now I can go ahead and lift my stencil up carefully, and it looks like I have the whole thing covered, which is good. Then I'm gonna go ahead and carefully flip this over and go ahead and set it down on my cardstock. Now I'm going to move this back a little bit because I need to lean in to go ahead and line this up. You know what? No, I don't want to do it that way. Alrighty, now I'm gonna go ahead and use my release paper and gently flatten the areas. I'm gonna go ahead and bring my large piece back here. And I see I lined the stencil up kind of crooked. It's okay, I'll just cut the panel. This is just for demonstration anyway. So I'm gonna go ahead and use the same flakes, the autumn leaves. And again, sprinkle it over. You don't need that much. And I'm probably putting more than I need to, but it's okay. I'll work it around. All right, so the same thing. Go ahead and go in and burnish your flakes over the exposed adhesive through the stencil. Okay, so it looks like I got it all in. Let's go ahead and wipe this up. Get our excess little pieces off. Let's go ahead and funnel the excess flakes back into the container. I mean, if you're not cheap like me, you can go ahead and throw it away. I like to save as much as possible. And look at that. Flakes everywhere. So yeah, just a reminder, these flakes are very, very lightweight and will fly away very easily. So yeah, this can be messy. If you don't mind getting messy, it's okay. So let's go ahead and close this up. Now I'm going to go ahead and carefully remove my stencil from the panel. And since I didn't line it up properly, it has a little piece there. So my stencil is coming up nicely since I had my perfect medium. Let's grab a palette knife real quick. So as you can see, my stencil came off nicely. And I have my gilding all on the inside. Now, all of the black is still the score tape. It's still adhesive. It's still sticky. So I'm going to go ahead and put glitter over this. So go ahead and lay your panel down. Grab your glitter, and it can be any kind of glitter you want. I'm putting a lot in. And I'm gonna go ahead and really rub that glitter into my score tape. Now this gives you a very, very pretty effect on your card or whatever you're using the panel that you're working on. So I'm really working that glitter in. Alrighty. So now I'm going ahead and just cleaning this up, making sure all my glitter gets removed. So the thing with the rock candy, it's not quite transparent, so it mutes the black a little bit, which for some people they don't mind. It depends all on what you want. Let's go ahead and get that over there. Oh. And I'm being so messy, I hate this. Okay. Alrighty. So now I'm gonna go ahead and do some more burnishing. Where's my phone folder? It would be helpful if I had that, now wouldn't it? My desk is a complete mess right now. My kids were in here and they were messing around with my stuff and moved my stuff around. So of course now I can't find anything. Okay, so here is what your panel looks like. You have the nice, beautiful foil ling from the gilding, which none of the glitter is on. And then you have the glitter over the black area from the cardstock. It makes it look more, it's not quite black, but you know what I'm talking about. You know what it looks like. So that is what it looks like. It's very, very easy to do. It's sparkly. And you can probably burnish the glitter in some more. I'm just not doing it for the tutorial because it's just going to take too long. But you can see if you love bling like I do, you have the beautiful gold and all the other colors. Let me go ahead and bring it up to see if you guys can see the colors here all around. It's just beautiful. So there you go. These are two different ways that you can use the gilding flakes, whether you're using die cuts. And remember, for the die cuts, you can prepare any type of die cuts and create your own background. So you can extend the use of all of your die cuts. As you guys saw on my cards, I used my Cherry Lynn's Gear Border Die and the Clock Die to make my own background. Here I'm using this one. And for this one, I use a stencil. So you can stretch out how you use all of your products. So let me know what you think. I'm not very good with tutorials. They're really not my thing. But I did this because a couple of subbies requested, and of course I wanted to go ahead and show them and see if I could help. I will be doing a video later on showing the gilding flakes with stamping. I don't have the proper adhesive to do the stamping. You need to either have the Cosmic Shimmer flake and glitter glue, or you need to have the Indigo Blue flitter glue. Now, this is a liquid glue, and you adhere, you know, you use a sponge, a special sponge, it's like a foam, and you're gonna go ahead and you're gonna put it all over your stamp. You're gonna then stamp your image onto your cardstock, and then you need to set it aside and let it pretty much dry. Once it dries, it stays tacky, and that's what's gonna hold your flakes. So when I get one of those glues, I will go ahead and show stamping with the gilding flakes. But for now, this is what I have because I don't have that glue. Alrighty, I'm out of here. Thanks so much for watching. At a later time, I'll probably create something with these panels and I'll come back and show you. So once again, if you have any questions, leave a comment below and let me know. Bye.